Good evening, everyone. My name is Gabriel Lofval, and I'm the artistic director for Chorus Angelicus in Gaudeamus, which is one of the choirs that is in front of you right now. Actually, that was a combination of the sopranos and altos from Chorus Angelicus in Gaudeamus and the combined choirs of St. Patrick's and Anthony Church in downtown Hartford. Now, we will actually just remain on the altar with Chorus Angelicus in Gaudeamus. And let me get to my super podium here. I'm short, so this thing helps greatly. Thank you. The next four pieces of the program are actually part of a beautiful residency that we had the pleasure to be part of in New York City. 3 weeks ago, we participated in a beautiful workshop with American composer Eric Whitaker and Stephen Schwartz. And the composers themselves were there, and we got to spend many hours of rehearsal. Probably 10 hours, right? Yes. Say yes. Yes. We spent time with them and prepared their pieces, and it was quite the experience. So we thought, why not to continue to provide those pieces for the public here? When we did it in New York, it was as part of a 250-piece choir. So it was quite a thrilling experience. And the hall was Lincoln Center. We did it at Avery Fisher Hall. So that was remarkable. But we like it better here in West Hartford, at this beautiful little chapel in the University of St. Joseph. And by the way, we are so grateful to Ezekiel Menendez, the organist here at the chapel, and the choir of St. Joseph, the University of St. Joseph, who is going to join us for the last piece for the Requiem. So right now we have four a cappella pieces for you. The first one is called Queramos. It's by Stephen Schwartz. And I really encourage you to read the poem as they sing the piece, because it's quite remarkable. A beautiful piece by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, just describing the cycle of life. And it's quite telling the way the composer actually describes this cycle of life. I'm sure you are going to hear that wheeling around that circle in the voices. And please follow up the program, the poem, because it's a remarkable piece. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mozart's well known for composing so many musicals, Wicked and Gospel, and so many famous Pippin and whatnot, but he really knows how to write for a choir, or for orchestra, I should say, because it's really orchestral writing. They did a great job in all those divisions, so thank God for a good day. It was wet today, so they were sounding a little on the flat side, because we all feel the wetness, but I think now with you in front, they are picking up. So thank you for being there. The next three songs are actually by Eric Whitaker, which is the superstar, the rock star of the choral world, and we're lucky to spend time with him and perform his pieces. The first one we're doing is A Boy and a Girl. He's a fan of poetry in Spanish, and he composed two of his major works based on the poetry of Mexican poet Octavio Paz, who's a Nobel laureate. So again, please follow in your programs the beautiful poetry. This Boy and a Girl describes, again, the circle of life. We tried with this concert to really take you on a journey for the soul and to inspire you, so that's for yourself to take a look at your life and to see where your journey is taking you. So we began the concert with a beautiful mat setting, very simple, by Gabriel Fauré, of course, the composer that we are highlighting in the program. And that was the Messe Bass. The Messe Bass is just a regular Catholic liturgy for every day. That's why it's a low mass, because it's a mass that can be performed any weekday. It's not a high mass on Sundays. And that's why that setting was so simple. I hope you heard that simplicity. Just organ, treble voices, because that's what he was working with at the church at the time, 100 and some years ago, right? So then we thought we would take you in this trip with a beautiful poetry of Longfellow, and now with this A Boy and a Girl, which describes a beautiful relationship between a boy and a girl who are alive and then they are not. So let's hear the poem recited by a true Mexican in Spanish. So if we he's there waiting. Excellent. That's Andrés Moreno García, everyone. And he will read the poem in Spanish, and afterwards we will perform it in English for your delight, so you can hear it.
Los novios. Tendidos en la hierba, una muchacha y un muchacho. Comen naranjas, cambian besos, como las olas cambian sus espumas. Tendidos en la playa, una muchacha y un muchacho. Comen limones, cambian besos, como las nubes cambian espumas. Tendidos bajo tierra, una muchacha y un muchacho. No dicen nada, no se besan. Cambian silencio por silencio.
people from all over the world to just record a piece. If they are, whoever is interested in choral singing can just sit in front of the computer. He sends the PDF of the score and a video of himself conducting the piece. And the only requisite is that you just send a videotape of yourself singing a part. And then with his little magic in the laboratory, he puts all these voices together and concocts a beautiful piece sung by 4,000 people from all over the world. So the last piece that he, of course, he makes a lot of money doing this, but that's part of the gist. And the last piece he wrote about this is called Fly to Paradise. The next, our next piece. And we thought it was such a beautiful part of the journey for the soul because it has to do with traveling to paradise. This is someone that forgot how to fly and then she remembered again. And I think that that happens to all of us through life regarding different situations. And it also ties in with the theme of the In Paradiso, which is the beautiful chant of commendation that we always sing at the funeral mass at the end when we say the final goodbye. So we thought it was very opportune to use that song for this program. The song features a soloist, which in the recording online, the virtual choir is actually Whitaker's wife, a wonderful soprano. But we have such wealth of talent with the children of Church of Chorus Angelicus that we have different soloists. And today's featured soloist is Michaela Botare. Michaela, please. And our wonderful Michaela has been in the program for how many years?
10 years.
She's been singing with Chorus Angelicus for 10 years. By the way, if you're wondering what this Chorus Angelicus is about, we are a choir school for children. We can teach your children how to sing. So if you have any children in your family, a son, a daughter, a niece, a nephew, you can send that child to us and we'll make them sing like Michaela. So just make sure you pay attention. And send us your children because that's the way we make our living, by teaching your children how to sing. So let's sing Fly to Paradise and featuring Michaela Botare, who is graduating this year and going to school for vocal performance at Westminster College in Princeton, New Jersey.
Thank you.
And our hosts, or hostesses for the day, the chamber choir of the University of St. Joseph, and our wonderful instrumentalist, the orchestra that we have to offer you what is Gabriel Fauré's first version of his Requiem. The Requiem is a very famous piece, and actually it did become famous. I'm going to follow this. It did become famous at the time the composer was alive. He lived long enough to see his piece really thrive to the degree that his publishers actually kept coming back to him and telling him to make that piece bigger, to compose it for a bigger orchestra, so larger choirs could sing along with it. And he went along, but his heart always stayed with the first version, which is the one you are about to hear. And it's very particular. If you pay attention, we have a wonderful little orchestra, chamber orchestra, of four violas in Tbilisi, playing that universe of low notes, and four cellos. So it's really this sepia tone, this color of beauty, just low tones, and a wonderful double bass. So it's really quite a particular orchestra. And we know that there is enough research to know that he did not like the version of the full orchestra. I'm actually saying that because we didn't have the money to hire the full orchestra. But it's true. He really always, his heart always stayed with this orchestra. And to complement, of course, the timpani always punctuating the rhythm and a wonderful harp. And one violin, only one high voice, to play what is the theme of the Requiem, a recurrent motif that you will hear movement after movement. And if you want to know what the motif is when you hear the first movement, it appears in the children's voice, is the Tedecem Imnum section. So pay attention when the children sing Tedecem Imnum, because that motif keeps appearing in the organ, in the solo violin, throughout the entire piece, in the cellos, and so it's a wonderful way to give the piece some tie together. So I hope you enjoy this journey for the soul, and we finish with a genre that has through the centuries inspired countless composers, that of the Requiem. And despite whether they are believers or not, despite their religion, composers always go to a Requiem, because composers write from the heart, and we are lucky to have many composers in the room, and the Requiem is a theme that touches us all, that of death. So enjoy it.